vinyl community. Curtis Young here with Young LP Lovers, coming at you tonight with a thread response. Thread response for Peter over at Music is a Journey. What a great name for a channel, right? Music is a Journey, isn't that the truth? On our journey tonight, we've got playing in the background, Wes Montgomery, the legendary Wes Montgomery. Windy, with a Beatles cover right now, I guess. That was given to me by a friend, so great album, that one. All right, so I was watching Chris over at Record Talk tonight, and he was doing this thread response. I know I'm a little late to the game, but I wanted to hop on anyway, because I liked his response, and I liked the questions. I thought the questions were kind of fun, and yeah, I just wanted to hop right onto it, even though I'm quite late already. So the challenge that was set up by Music is a Journey was kind of three categories. You wanted one song for each category. Okay, so I'm gonna jump right into it. The first category was a second language, a non-English language song, right? And I thought that was cool because language is quite important for myself and my family. You know, my wife speaks Spanish and I speak English. My kids grew up with Mandarin and English and Spanish. And now my older daughter's now learning French since we've returned to Canada. So I thought that was cool. So I've been listening to a lot of Latin soul, kind of the New York scene from the late 60s and 70s, particularly the Boogaloo stuff has been really on my turntable a lot. But I decided to go with CDs because Peter's over in Japan and his collection is CD based. And so I wanted to start with CDs and I wanted to start with a Japanese CD. Yeah, so this is the Japanese OB here. This is Shakira's third studio album. And this was really her breakthrough album, really, where she became much more popular outside of Colombia and got picked up in America and so forth. And so the name of the album is it, I don't know which is first. Oh, there it is. Pies Descalzos. Yeah, Pies Descalzos. So that would be calloused feet. And you can see the calloused feet on the back. So the breakthrough track on this, or the big one anyway, the first single, the one that really kind of caught fire, was Estoy Aquí, I Am Here. So that one did really well, and it topped the Billboard Latin charts, and maybe even, yeah, probably the Billboard Latin charts. I think it made it number one. But what I'm going to do here is I'm going to give you some needle drops on each one of these, or I guess laser drops, as it were. And so I'm gonna go with track number three, Un Poco de Amor. Now, this is a little bit maybe atypical of her music, to be honest. This one has kind of a reggae beat to it. And as a reggae fan, you know, that appeals to me. So I first learned about Shakira in university. I had a classmate, a dorm mate, who had spent some time in Colombia, and he had a mixed CD and it was on there and we kind of liked it and grooved to it, and I've been a fan ever since. So yeah, this is the song Un Poco de Amor by Shakira, 1995, I want to say. Is there any date on here? Pretty sure it's 95. Enjoy. right. So the next category was a city of importance to you. So find a track with a city name in the title. So immediately I kind of was thinking, went downstairs to my record collection, my CD collection, I'm sorry, and I pulled out this album. And kind of broke my heart, I'll tell you why in a second. But I don't know a lot about this album, so it's China Lounge featuring Shanghai Divas. And it's kind of like ambient electronica music with a lot of oriental elements in the music. The track I'm gonna play for you is by, so it's multiple artists, it's a compilation. I'm not familiar with any of these, to be honest. Like, I don't know them very well. But there's one called Dub Driver, Red Buddha appears here a couple of times, Linda Wong, etc. The one I'm going to play for you is the Shanghai Restoration Project and Miss Shanghai. Of course, Shanghai is really important to me. We spent 12 years in Shanghai. Picked this up not long after I got there, somewhere between 2010 and 2012. You know, both my kids were born there and so forth, so Shanghai is pretty important. But what broke my heart about this is when I opened it up to get the CD, it was empty. Ah, bummer. I did find some of the tracks online on Spotify, so that's where you're going to get the sample from. I don't know what happened to the CD. It's probably in a CD player that I left in Shanghai. I looked through a few other places to find it, but it's not there, so I fear that it didn't make it in the move. But hey, I did burn this onto my computer, so I do have a burned copy of this. So that's somewhere. It's not this computer, it's my old computer. So I do have it somewhere. But so once again, this is Miss Shanghai, the Shanghai Restoration Project. Feature a local artist, someone from your local area. When it comes to local artists, I'd have to say probably my favorite, I think it's would be Slow Coaster. Slow Coaster are from Cape Breton, Nova Scotia, as am I. And what can I say? They're a three-piece group. So you got Mike Levine on the bass. You've got Steve McDougall on guitar. And I've been through a couple different drummers. The current drummer, I can't remember his name. I'll have to look it up and I'll put it on the screen. I think during these sessions, Brian Talbot, I believe, was the drummer. This, I think, is their first album, I believe. It's only, what, six tracks? So it's a short album. So it goes way back to 2003. It's kind of hard to believe that that was 20 years ago. So they became a big act on the local festival scene, and it brings me really back to that time. They have a new album that just came out a couple of months ago called Apples and Oranges. The digital version is out. I'm waiting on the vinyl. This is their first album they released on vinyl. Their first album in about 5 years. But okay, so this, what kind of music are they? So they have very much a reggae backbeat to it, okay, which appeals a lot to me. It's very, very groove heavy, very danceable, hence the festival success. But they also have like folk elements thrown in there. They come from here on the island, Cape Breton Island. There's a very strong singer-songwriter culture, and that infuses their music as well. So there's a lot of fun stories. They're clearly tongue-in-cheek. They have the humor of the area, which is very tongue-in-cheek at times. They're humorous. Even here, you can see like this is their bass player in the back. I don't know what happened. I lost the cover of this, but I just have the CD and the thing. So I think the track I'm going to play for you is "Can't Get High." So Slow Coaster, "Can't Get High." Check it out. That is it. Those are my three choices for Music is a Journey. I'll leave the link to his channel down below. Go check out his channel. Hop on the threads. Peace.